a river. It shapes our life as it shapes the land that it flows through. It was here before us and hopefully will be here after we're gone, and it's up to us to ensure its flow. The Chipola is one of these rivers. This is part of its story and how we're helping it continue to flow.
I think the Chipola River is special because it is one of our spring-fed systems, and Florida springs are so unique and so beautiful. You get to, you know, paddle down a crystal clear water that has, you know, unique species of fish, and I think that just is part of the richness of Florida and one of those experiences that people can have getting out in nature.
This river is probably one of the most beautiful rivers I've ever been on. It's got so many different types of habitat. It can be clear blue one day and completely muddy the next day. And there's all different shoals, there's trees crossing, there's trees under the water. It's just a fun float.
The threats to the Chipola River are urbanization and agricultural practices, but was designated as a preservation basin in the State Wildlife Action Plan, meaning that it's still in pretty good relative condition. And so there's a few areas that need restoration and enhancement, and addressing those are going to make it even better than it already is.
Prioritize some of these habitat areas, such as low water stream crossings and erosion and sedimentation that may be affecting the river. So I think educating the public on water usage and certainly working on some of the habitat restoration sites that we've been working on, I think are things that we're doing that are combating some of the threats that occurred for this river.
Well, people are aware of the largemouth bass in Florida. It's our most popular freshwater species. But what a lot of people don't know is we have three other species of black bass that live in Florida panhandle rivers. And they have limited geographical range. They're very unique genetically, and it's important that we preserve them.
I think it's very important to conserve shoal bass. It's, you know, the uniqueness of this species is about as unique as it gets in the state. It's the only river in the state where we have a reproducing population.
You know, a lot of like smallmouth bass, you know, they'll suck on your thumb, so you don't even have to hold them. These don't do that. I just tried. Sight cast these unless they're in the shadow.
I love chasing IGFA world records as it takes me to unique places. It opens my eyes to different habitats, different species, and for this past week I got to pursue and target the shoal bass. That took me to a spring-fed river that I would have never knew existed in Florida. My exposure to Florida has always been saltwater and bass fishing. And the bass fishing has taken me to lakes and really cloudy rivers. And so this was the first time I'd ever seen a clear spring-fed river in Florida. One of the coolest things I think that I saw this week in fishing the Chipola River was the results and the effects of the FWC and their research. Several of the shoal bass that I caught had clip fins where they have come in during shocking and taken measurements and really taken stock of what the river does hold and possess. And it was awesome to see that they're thriving and hopefully growing and getting bigger. This week I caught two world records, a black crappie and a shoal bass. One was a surprise, a black crappie, and I think that was really one of the benefits of having such an incredible fishery is that it's not just single species. We identified and saw probably over 8 different species as we floated down the river. It's really great to see various organizations from across the nation come together for a place like the Chipola.
Whether you're here in Florida trying to save shoal bass or whether you're in Virginia trying to save brook trout, the things that you need to build the partnerships to accomplish that are what the National Fish Habitat Program is trying to promote. So just the finding those common elements, finding the right tools that you need, and of course the money. The money is such a big part of it and so very hard to come by. The more we can aggregate our efforts together, the better we can do.
It's not just about, you know, this is what needs to be done and this is how we should go about it. It's about having a conversation and building a relationship so that we can all benefit, whether it be in the same way or in different ways.
The charm of the Chipola and other rivers like it is in the experience that it provides. None are the same, yet each one is deeply meaningful in its own right. Each interaction is remarkable, beautiful, and unique. This river flows through our state, our cities, and our hearts, and while partnerships have been forged to protect this extraordinary resource, it is up to us to preserve it for future generations.